DevOps, as we know, is not just a set of tools or a team or a role. It is a mindset. We went through it in detail in our DevOps Simplified video. Please check it out. Link is available in top right corner. No matter where you are in DevOps roadmap, or you are a beginner looking for a change to DevOps career, or you can be part of a team already, or you are in the journey for years now. So no matter where you are on this road, all the time you will end up trying to figure out the right tools to bring up the best DevOps practices and reap its full benefits. So the biggest question, where to start your tools treasure tree? Let's break it down in this video. This is Naren Krish and you are watching. So let me start this video with a big question. Is there a strategic way to identify the right tools? Where and how one should start that activity of identifying the right tools? There are a huge number of resources available on the internet. I'm going to explain one way of doing this. Do comment below if your approach is different so that we can help the community together. If you're new to DevOps and would like to understand how to sail through it, check out a DevOps roadmap video linked above. Let's go through the process of DevOps tool selection. I would call this a mind map. It's going to be a little theory at first, but a necessary one. As I told, DevOps is a mindset, so theories are important. Watch the video till the end. I'll be providing you links to good resources to make an informed decision that is supported by standards. That way you can explain this to your boss why you are suggesting one tool over the other. So watch till the end. Firstly, scope your features. Before jumping into tools, identify and discuss the features that you and your team is looking at. What is the mission, vision, and future of your organization? This is an important step. We don't want to jump into tools without knowing which features we are looking for. Otherwise, we might end up with a complex tool that can do lots of things, but features you really want are hard to use or sometimes not even available. The second step I would suggest would be know your existing technology stack. Even if DevOps is new for your organization, it is better to look at your existing technology, as tools will mostly operate hand in hand and they form an ecosystem. For example, if your team is using Jira for ticketing, maybe Bitbucket can be considered as a source code management tool. As it provides pre-integration in workflow, you can see linked Jira tickets in your Bitbucket and your branches in Jira, etc. Wait, before you jump and challenge why not open source, all I am saying is tools most of the time will not operate independently. They form an ecosystem. It's not just that. They might have a bundle license for such pre-integrated tools as well. It will be certainly cheaper comparing to buying these tools from different vendors. Think of it like owning an iPhone, iPad, and a MacBook. You don't get discounts there, but you understand the advantage of the ecosystem. So consider that. Understand your existing stack. It can be that your org has an open source stack. Example, if you're using Prometheus for metrics, consider using Grafana for dashboard. What I'm suggesting is try to pick preferable tools from within your organization technology stack so that you can filter the vast available on the internet. Other benefits are easy adoption within your organization, cost reduction, and the upper hand in bargaining with your existing software vendors. The next thing we can think of is self-hosted versus managed solutions, which is to decide whether you want to host the solution yourself or you're looking at software as a service, like cloud hosted services. I mean to say, you want to use Jenkins for your CI, the question is whether you want to run it in a Unix box on-prem or cloud, or you want to use externally hosted solutions like CircleCI, Travis, etc. The next step is look at the industry trend. On tools available and tools being used by top players, I first look at CNCF landscape. If you are hearing CNCF for the first time, it is Cloud Native Computing Foundation, which builds and organizes the ecosystem around cloud native tools. Even though it targets cloud native, but it neatly organizes all the tools you can even install on on-premise or on local machine. I would highly recommend you to come here when you won't know what the industry is doing in this area. Okay, what you have to do is to click on projects, go to interactive landscape. If you have already seen it, welcome back. If you are new here, don't get overwhelmed by this huge list. Let's break it down. They have very nicely organized the tools based on its functions. This is important. This will help scope your focus. We'll discuss it shortly. They have these easy filters to interact. For example, you want to check only open sources? Be their guest. As from our previous steps of scoping features and knowing your existing stack, you can filter out this huge list and get closer look. The next one I would recommend is DevOps Periodic Table from digital.ai. Now, this is not very exhaustive, but it claims to have 20k votes and around 400 products considered for initial voting. So, kind of gives you an industry trend too. Talking about trends, we also published sneak peek trending tools in our Trending Thursday series around DevOps. So, do check that out in our playlist. So, subscribe and click on the notification bell icon if you have not done that yet. Next step, I would call it as social proofing. It's a term coined by Robert Cialdini in his 1984 book Influence. It describes a psychological and social phenomenon wherein people copy the actions of others in an attempt to undertake behavior in a given situation. In other words, interact with the people in your industry and those who have used the tools for years, because tool selection is not just about knowing the advantage of your tool, but also knowing the shortcomings. This is very, very important. None of the articles or sales brochures is going to highlight these issues with the tool. So better interact with the people in DevOps area, check in forums, so that you get the feedback from the actual users. They know the actual pain of the product. Example, don't just go for Kubernetes just because industry trends to it. But you should understand the pitfalls and complexity of any tool and should make an informed decision. This is very important perspective. Most of the time we miss this perspective and we end up with the same mess others are in. By the way, Kubernetes was just an example I picked up. It's a great tool and I'm a big fan. That reminds me, don't miss this free webinar on Advanced Kubernetes Concepts Simplified. That's coming up next week. Link in the description to register for it. It's a free masterclass. Before going to Udemy or Plural site and spend your hard-earned money on the courses, do check this free series I've made as Kubernetes basic series linked on the top right corner as well. So that's what social proofing is all about. Finally, I meant the last, but not the least, scope your stack. I often see we end up too much excited and start looking into all possible tools for every steps in your DevOps pipeline. Reality is you just can't implement or roll out all of them in a single shot because it takes time to set up, validate, and roll out the tools, and not to mention about the adoption within your organization. So scope it. I mean, maybe just target decent source code management, a CI, automated testing tools as a first step. Then start thinking about monitoring, logging, or you can decide the other way around. Maybe you are spending more time in monitoring and you want to roll out a good monitoring tool first so that you can reduce the time your team is spending in monitoring things manually or using some broken scripts that always fails. So scope it. One bonus tip that I promised is how to present this. Though PowerPoint is my personal preference for technology stack, it will take time to build one. So I looked up and noticed that for you, you can use this one. I'll recommend zebiellabs.com. That actually helps you to quickly build your technology stack by just typing the tools you use or you are planning to use. It might not have full list of tools, but does a pretty good job. Let's try building one quickly. Once you select all the tools, it will ask you for the details about you. Just quickly fill them up and then you will get this nicely presented diagram. actually. You can enrich more information at this time. Like say, I want to add Trello as my project management tool. After tinkering a little, you can download this. Which will come as an image and you can add it to your presentation. In the end, add your pinch of style and you're good. Hope this video was informational. Do subscribe for more such videos. And this is Narendra Krish signing off. Thanks for watching and keep learning.